In response to the Deepwater Horizon oil spill, the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission and its partners acted quickly to protect and conserve threatened and endangered sea turtles from the possible impacts of oil. Working with BP's Vessels of Opportunity program, rescue boats went out daily to the eastern zone of the spill area, where FWC staff recovered approximately 130 visibly oiled sea turtles. Spotters stood on the boat's fishing towers, and captains maneuvered close enough so biologists could capture turtles with handheld nets. Using GPS, biologists recorded the location of the turtles and collected data on environmental conditions. They closely examined them for oil, took samples, measured, weighed, and photographed each turtle. Biologists pit tagged and returned those not impacted by the oil to the Gulf. Impacted turtles were transported to Gulf World in Panama City Beach for primary care, where they were cleaned of all external oil and received initial treatment until they were stable enough to be moved to a secondary care facility. Once medically cleared for transfer, the turtles were taken to SeaWorld Orlando, where they completed their rehabilitation and were housed until they met established release criteria. The first release of rehabbed sea turtles occurred on August 18th at Cedar Key. 23 Kemp's Ridleys received an honorable send-off by Admiral Thad Allen and Dr. Jane Lubachenko, administrator of NOAA, with FWC and NOAA staff assisting. Another effort involved the hundreds of turtle nests on Florida's Panhandle beaches, which are marked by FWC-authorized permit holders who walk the beaches every morning during nesting season. After much discussion and deliberation, scientists decided to take the unprecedented step to have the hatchlings released in the Atlantic Ocean. FWC biologists and its partners worried that when hatchlings from the nests made it to the Gulf, currents would likely bring them into contact with floating oil, creating a deadly environment for the tiny critters. Beginning in early July, excavations of nests began 3 days per week. Biologists decided the least risky and most feasible approach would be to move the entire clutch of eggs late in the incubation period between days 45 and 50, after gender was already determined and the magnetic cues that help turtles return to their beach of birth hopefully would have already been imprinted. When the clutch of eggs was uncovered, each egg was slowly lifted out of the nest and then laid on top of sand from the nest in specially prepared foam coolers. A wire coupler was placed in the cooler on the first layer of eggs so the temperature of the nest could be accurately monitored. The coolers were taken to a holding area where they awaited arrival of the turtle trucks from FedEx. These specially outfitted trucks drove from the Panhandle across the state to Cape Canaveral, where the Kennedy Space Center offered climate-controlled storage facilities. Biologists closely monitored the coolers, and as hatchlings emerged, they were released under the cloak of darkness and made their way to the oil-free waters of the Atlantic Ocean. More than 13,000 hatchlings have been released since early July. These incredible journeys for the sea turtles of Florida's northwest coast could only have been accomplished through partnering with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, NOAA's National Marine Fisheries Service, the National Park Service, Florida's Department of Environmental Protection, and the collaboration of many partners and individuals determined to give these turtles a fighting chance for survival.